with Corel WordPerfect Suite, an exceptionally intuitive processor.
Coming up, the moment when Rosse knew that he won the first set. Break away to have a look at the environ of this outstanding court, the Suzanne Long court, formerly Court A. Steffen Edberg serving at the start of this second set. It's only the second set he's dropped to Rosse in this, their fourth meeting. But he dropped the first set to Chiang and came back in utterly convincing style, played an absolutely staggering third set, which he won 6-love, beat the number four seed in four sets. Can you repeat that?
Well, the idea was good.
Oh. Right on the line. But Rosse watched it like a hawk and watched it go on and off.
Good forehand. I have to repeat myself, you have to play the shot that is the opponent's strength. You cannot be scared of that shot.
No. Rosse wasn't expecting it there. Weight on the left foot. After that, but Rosse is proving a mighty tough nut to crack here. Edberg a game up, Rosse a set up.
For the perfect meal every time, all you need is a generous helping of Bordeaux. Just open, pour and enjoy immediately. Pasta with a dash of Bordeaux.
I'll tell you something. The way this point's going, get comfortable, because we could be here a while. Super.
Mark Rosse has taken his tablets, but doesn't seem to be ailing too much. And certainly inwardly, whatever medically is going on, he'll be feeling pleased with what he's done.
Well, that was a sharp volley from Edberg. It was not an easy one to make, that backhand volley.
That's a really good touch.
Well, theoretically, he shouldn't win this point, Rosse, because having stepped around the backhand to hit the forehand approach shot, he's so far out of court. But he's so tall and he moves well. He gets back into position very, very quickly and plays a lovely touch forehand volley.
Yes, I got into trouble for trying to say that really big men don't have great coordination, so I wouldn't even bother to say that really big men don't have great touch. Two sporting characters. There'll be little for Roland Herfel to do here.
But it was a very late call, and linesman actually waited for Mark to say it was out.
Yeah, he can be noisy. Jakob Plasek there, the Swiss compatriot. Very much the quieter of the two. World Team Cup champions, those two in Dusseldorf. Terrific for Swiss. And both have continued their form here into the French Open.
Finally, we get a second serve out wide to the forehand. And it's a pretty good one as well. Certainly caught Rosse unawares.
Still serving wide out to the backhand. Beautifully constructed rally.
Really got a lot of angle on that backhand, making it very, very difficult for Rosse to catch up to it.
A lot of luck there for Stefan, both of the line, then the net court. But Rosse not playing quite as well as he was in the tiebreak. Edberg leads 2-1. You're with us on the Suzanne Longlong court. Marc Rosset, the number 14 seed, is set up against Stefan Edberg, a finalist here in 1989. Rosset 1-2. Third ace.
So if you get a second serve, you really don't want to mess it up. You don't get that many opportunities to attack that second serve.
Yes, Rosset a little bit on his heels there. May have jarred himself at the end of that run.
So he hits the second serve and then goes back half a metre. So it's a good shot to play the drop shot. Not an easy one to do on a returner serve.
The Rosset serve certainly firing better. Although his all-court game perhaps not quite as good as it was. It's a badge you would have been proud to wear, Bob. The umpire's friend. It's gone very quiet.
Silence is golden. Again, not an easy volley to make. It looks like it was an unforced error. I suppose when you think about it, it was, because he shouldn't have missed it. But again, he had the pressure of the ball just skimming the net.
Big second serve now. Love 30. Two games all. Again, it's long, but that time it was weak. Break point for Rosset, his first break point of the game, of the set rather. Oh, Stefan. Why on earth did he take his racket away from that? Didn't seem to be mishit. A criminal error, it's 3-2. Plenty of style around this Suzanne Longlong court at Roland Garros. And Marc Rosset taking advantage of Stefan Edberg, not quite as good as he has been this week. can he find the inspiration? The one Grand Slam tournament, Stefan's not won. He's won two Australians, two Wimbledons, two US Opens. Finalist here in 89. What a story it would be if he could win in his last year as a pro.
I'm quite certain he'd give up one of each of them, the other ones, just have one win there, just to have one French.
Ross did well. Again, footwork betrayed him, but he recovered. See the 202 in the corner there. The serve is really beginning to pick up. Rossi is in charge now. First time either man's really been in charge of a match, but Stefan's not the boss.
No, and during the last changeover, he changed his shoes. Same company, same style, same everything. He didn't feel very comfortable. Something was wrong with the other ones. This court, Susan Longman court, a little bit faster than the other courts, perhaps a little bit slippery, and so he needed a fresher pair of shoes.
Normally he can make backhands like that in his sleep.
He's under pressure now. Turn up the middle, a little bit high. And that's just his bread and butter volley. I can still only remember the one serve right up that center line. That was an ace. Served a few to the forehand, but not right up the center.
And Rossi is really latching onto the serve now. He's such a bright man, Stefan, and such an intelligent tennis player. I'm glad you're here alongside me to call it, but it does seem dumbfounding that he won't serve down the centre. I do it the other side. But he holds on. He looked to be rocking again for a while. But Rossi has a grasp on this match at the moment. He leads by a set and 4-3 in the second.
Official partner of the French Open.
Sense almost of disappointment at the moment around the court because the non-committed came here rooting for Stefan, and at the moment it doesn't look to be going that way, so everyone's a little quiet.
Very much so. You need something to lift the spirits of all the fans, and the best way to do that is to win a set.
Yes, and 202K's serves from Matt Rossi don't help.
No, not at all.
But he's playing really well, Rossi. Let's take nothing away from him.
Oh.
Well, you said he's playing well, and I was about to say that he's very, very sharp. And it's amazing how often one gives a player a compliment, only to see them play one or two of the worst shots that absolutely imaginable.
Boom. No, it was okay. Surprised he wants it checked. He definitely hit a bit of the line. Ace number five. There might be a mark alongside the line, but it was fine. Some of the ball definitely got some of the line. Fifth ace.
Cancel.
He does sometimes play a single-handed backhand, Rosset. Seems to be doing it more and more these days. Forcing. Didn't get through that ball. One can visualize a couple of days ago against Chang how well he hit through the ball when he wanted to go down the line and how often he hit great shots.
Oh, terrific play from Edberg. What a return. And then the pass.
Powerful serve, the return a little bit short, and in comes Rosset. Now he's got to get back close to the center, and then that makes it difficult for him to change direction.
Now the crowd getting involved. Break back point for Edberg. Well done. He had to pass him. He knew that when he tossed the ball up.
Didn't hit the return that he was looking for. Mishit it a little bit, but he was committed to coming into the net.
He needed one more shot than he should have done. Oh, lovely stuff.
It was pretty positive from both players. Great forehand pass, though, from Rosset.
Terrific. Edberg then serving to stay in the second set. 3-5. Perilously close. Now, Rosset initially gave the point away. He's done that. That's really good to see.
Mm-hmm. Well, having said that, or agreeing with you, it's the player's duty to hit the ball, not necessarily to call the balls. It's the umpire's job. But all Marc Rosset was doing there was just saving the umpire the fact that he had to come down from the chair. keep his energy level up high, the umpire, so he can concentrate. You're going to lose the argument, whatever happens. So this way it makes it look good, you see. You fell for it.
Hewitt still doing his piece for officialdom.
Well, I've become very friendly with a lot of umpires since I retired.
I've noticed. They said a leopard couldn't change his spots, but my word. It's getting to be a habit. These howitzers coming either side of Stefan time after time now, and he's 2 points from coming two sets down. It happens, but rarely at such a difficult time. Seventh double fault. And here are two set points for Marc Rossi of Switzerland. Got his footwork all wrong, then he thought it was going out. A couple of mistakes there, but Edberg saves the first set point. Yes. Terrific play from Marc Rossi. He's playing a very solid game indeed, with some rich highlights as well. Rossi leads 2-0.
Euro 96 is here with comprehensive coverage on Eurosport. The greatest footballing nations in Europe face up to each other in England, the home of football. Gascoigne, Platt and Adams, the trio that could give England a first European Championship title. Euro 96 kicks off at noon on Saturday, followed at 8 p.m. by England, Switzerland on Eurosport. With Coca-Cola, always for the fans. And Opel.
The fairy tale could be about to end. He's not played badly, but just not as well as he has done. And Marc Rossi has given him nothing. Nothing except howitzers and bullet serves and some pretty intelligent play. The aces count beginning to move up fairly rapidly now. It was just one in the first set, which was a tiebreak set. Now we're in to his sixth. Wasn't bad coordination either.
That's very good coordination. He got himself out of position. And, nearly hurt himself.
He's lucky he hit the ball. And he's hitting more and more forehands, Rossi, which has got to be worse and worse news for Edberg. One love.
for the perfect meal every time. All you need is a generous helping of Bordeaux. Just open, pour, and enjoy immediately. Pasta with a dash of Bordeaux.
Diadora, light your fire.
The richness and savoir-faire of a region. The balance of a prestigious wine. Malzin Bordeaux, first in France.
Back live to the French Open from Roland Garros with Carel Word Perfect Suite, an exceptionally intuitive processor.
Crowd trying to get Stefan going. I don't think he's lacking any adrenaline, but what he's lacking is an opponent who'll help him out here. Marc Rossi, devastating form. Love one, third set. The Swiss is up two sets.
Again, you see the great backhand volley.
Ah, serve down the middle.
Finally.
Oh. Another forehand creamed.
See, as Stefan is about to hit the ball, Mark is already moving a little bit to his left. He's going to commit himself to run around the ball. That's why I'm saying that Stefan has got to hit the odd second serve to the forehand. There's a risk involved, of course, but you know, when you lead 40 love on your serve, perhaps the risk is worth it.
Well, goes true to pattern, 40-30, he won't do it. Yes! Again, just a fraction slow to get off the mark, but when he got there, a devastating result.
Well, it's a mishit return of serve, and that's a very, very difficult backhand volley that Edberg had to make. He couldn't get enough power nor length. Good play there from Rosso with the forehand pass.
So for 40 love, deuce. Oh, another pass. And now another break point. This is a must-win point for Stefan.
Too much up the middle, making it too easy to run around the backhand.
This for two games to love. It's out!
He was.
Stefan put the racket up, and I think. Well, he's the most honest guy, Marc Rossi. Totally unassuming, but what a mess. Stefan putting the racket up may have distracted him.
Well, I don't know if it did or not, but I have a feeling that he was thinking that maybe he should hit the guy up the other end, and then decided, no, I better not.
Yeah, it's Stefan Edberg, after all. You get no marks for that. Though one or two I can think of, but you might get one or two.
Oh,
And there is something right out of context. A simple backhand volley. And Rossi, having made a real mess of the first break point, have a second. He went down the middle there. Fine second serve.
Great second serve, outstanding.
How many passes has he made down Stefan's backhand wing? Break point number three.
See, again, it's not cross-court, the volley, but it's not down the line either. It's too much up the middle.
I think Stefan thought it was going to go down the line. Would he really try and go cross-court from there? Yes, he would. And there's the result. And that may be the beginning of the end.
Oh dear.
Only his second double. All Rossi's got to do is keep serving like this, and he's home. Edberg hasn't broken him since the opening game.
Very, very heavy, that serve. It comes at you and it almost breaks your arm when you hit the ball.
It's the quickest so far. He wasn't sure whether to run round it or not.
No doubt the Swiss are happy with this situation. Not only do they have Rossi in the round of 16, but he's looking pretty good at the moment. Perhaps most of their thoughts were going for Martina Hingis and the ladies, but she's out.
It's amazing that Rossi hasn't achieved more. When you see him play like this in a big occasion, in Grand Slams, never beyond the round of a last 16.
It is amazing because he is a good player.
Ace number seven. Rossi leads now by two sets and three love, and he's moving out of sight of Stefan Edberg.
Join Eurosport on the road to Euro 96. In our lead up to this summer's European Championship, we look at the qualifying matches, examine all 16 teams in the competition, and profile the star players. Follow the road to Euro 96, Tuesday night at 11 p.m. on Eurosport. This programme is brought to you by Coca-Cola, always for the fans. And Carlsberg. Back live to Roland Garros with Peugeot, official partner of the French Open.
Just in case we forgot where we were. Really is a great addition to the complex here to Roland Garros. Those stats we might have expected even if Edberg was a couple of sets up. New ball, let's see if it brings him new fortune. Love three in the third set.
Having played so well up until this stage and playing not as well, he might also be very anxious, maybe even a little bit embarrassed.
Embarrassed?
Well, it might be because, you know, I think a lot of people expected more from him in this match because he'd given so much in the other matches. Maybe he thought more of himself as well.
Just disappointed, I can live with. Embarrassed, I don't know. Rosso's playing so well.
Yeah, but he won't feel that he's playing as well in himself. Good scramble, just couldn't do enough with it. Easily put away.
Can't keep it away from Rosso's forehand. Same side, same result. And now break point for a second break, and this would be insurance for Matt Rosso.
From the baseline to baseline and the passing shots on the forehand from Rosso, it seems like about 90% of the great shots have been the off forehand, and still Stefan hasn't really read them.
It's a moment of irony. Starting to go for the serve down the centre now, from the ad court. Oof. Eighth, double fault.
He's tried a couple of times the second serve out wide on the first court. He's gotten away with it most of the time.
Yep. Well done. Saved the situation. Still a breakdown. Three opportunities he has to break Rosset's serve. If you can't take one of them, it's goodbye to Roland Garros. Edberg also out of the doubles, he and Peter Korda, the number 14 seeds, but beaten by Jared Palmer and Jonathan Stark in the third round.
Such a heavy serve, it's tough to do more than what Edberg did there on the return.
Edberg's footwork is not as good now. It's as if Rosset's knocked the stuffing out of it.
See, he's trying to keep the ball away from, or he's trying to get the ball away from the forehand. And by doing that, he's trying to play the little angle cross court, which is okay. But he hasn't really thought to go down the line with the backhand. That would admittedly go to the forehand, but then that opens up the next shot to the backhand.
Yes, a few groans of disappointment now. Rosset leads 4-1 and by 2 sets.